Now we will determine T ratios for 270 degree minus theta. Theta is always an acute angle, so 270 minus theta will always lie in third quadrant. And in third quadrant, we know that tan and cot are positive, and rest all T ratios are negative. So if we have to take 270 minus theta, then for that we will have to consider this angle, means angle made by our rotating line OP with negative y axis as theta. If this angle will be theta, then this angle made by rotating line with positive direction of x axis will be 270 degree minus theta. Now for 270 degree minus theta, the perpendicular will be drawn from point P on reference line, that is on x-axis, say foot of the normal is N. Then for 270 degree minus theta, perpendicular being along negative y-axis will be negative, while base along negative x-axis will be negative. But if angle POY dash is theta, then in triangle OPN, angle OPN will also be theta, being alternate angle. So for angle theta, perpendicular will be ON and base will be PN. But for 270 minus theta, PN was perpendicular, ON was base. Hence, in case of 270 degree, perpendicular and base interchange. Due to this interchange of perpendicular and base, sine and cos, tan and cot, sec and cosec will interchange. If we want to calculate sine 270 minus theta, then for sine 270 minus theta, perpendicular PN will be negative. So minus PN upon hypotenuse OP is always positive. And for angle theta, PN is base, while OP is hypotenuse and will be positive because theta is an acute angle. So it will be minus cos theta. Cos 270 minus theta, for 270 minus theta, base will be minus ON, hypotenuse will be OP, but for theta, ON is perpendicular, so ON upon OP will be sine theta, hence it will give minus sine theta. For tan 270 minus theta, for 270 minus theta, perpendicular minus PN and base minus ON, so minus will get cancelled and PN upon ON is base upon perpendicular for angle theta, so it will give cot theta. Similarly, cot 270 minus theta being in third quadrant, cot will be positive. And case of 270 degree, interchange of perpendicular of base is there, so cot will change into tan theta. For sec 270 minus theta, we will get a negative sign because in third quadrant sec will be negative, and it is the case of 270 degree in which there is interchange of perpendicular and base, so sec will change into cosec to give minus cosec theta. Here cosec 270 minus theta will give minus sec theta. Minus because cosec in third quadrant is negative and it is the case of 270, so cosec will change into sec. These T ratios can be used to find out the values of sec 210 degrees. Say it can be written as sec 270 degree minus 60 degree, because 270 minus 60 will be 210, and sec 270 minus theta is minus cosec theta, so it will give minus cosec 60 degree, and sine 60 is root 3 by 2, so it will give 2 by root 3 with negative sign, minus 2 by root 3. Now cot 225 degree, it can be written as cot 270 degree minus 45 degree, and cot 270 minus theta will be 10 theta, because in third quadrant cot is positive, and being the case of 270 degree, cot will change into 10, and 10 45 degree is 1, so its value will be 1. Now we come to sine 240 degree. It can be written as sine 270 degree minus 30 degree, and sine 270 minus theta is minus cos theta, so it will give minus cos 30 degree. Cos 30 is root 3 by 2, so minus root 3 by 2. Now we come to the t ratios for 270 degree plus theta. In order to find t ratios for 270 degree plus theta, we will take angle made by rotating line OP with negative y axis as theta. If this angle will be theta, then this total angle made by line with positive direction of x axis will become 270 degree plus theta. And for 270 plus theta, perpendicular will be obtained by drawing a normal from P on base, that is on x axis. And if foot of the normal is M, then for 270 degree plus theta, perpendicular PN will be negative, while base ON will be positive. And if angle POY dash is theta, then angle OPN will also be theta, being alternate angle. And for angle theta, which is an acute angle, perpendicular will be ON and base will be PN, while hypotenuse still remains OP. It means in this case also, perpendicular and base interchange for 270 plus theta and theta. Hence again we will obtain change of sine into cos, or cos into sine, tan into cot, or cot into tan, like that. Now sine 270 degree plus theta will be perpendicular minus PN upon hypotenuse OP. But for angle theta, PN is base and hypotenuse is OP. Being acute angle, value will be positive, so it will be minus cos theta. When we come to cos 270 plus theta, then for cos 270 plus theta, base will be ON, while hypotenuse OP, and both will be positive. So it will give ON upon OP. And for angle theta, ON is perpendicular, and perpendicular upon hypotenuse is sine theta, so this time it will give positive sine theta. Now tan 270 plus theta, tan 270 plus theta will be perpendicular minus PN upon base plus ON, and for angle theta, PN will be base while ON will be perpendicular, and base upon perpendicular will be cot theta, so it will give minus cot theta. Now cot 270 degree plus theta in the same way will become minus 10 theta, and sec 270 degree plus theta, sec is positive in fourth quadrant, so this ratio will be positive. It is the case of 270 degree, so sec will change into cosec, so it will give cosec theta. Now cosec 270 degree plus theta will change into sec theta, but 270 degree plus theta being in fourth quadrant, in fourth quadrant cosec will be negative, so it will give minus sec theta. And we can use these values of t ratios to find a few other values, like tan 300 degree. It can be written as tan 270 degree plus 30 degree, and tan 270 plus theta is minus cot theta, so it will be minus cot 30 degree, and cot 30 is tan 60, it means minus root 3. Now sine 315 degree can be written as sine 270 plus 45 degree, and sine 270 plus theta is minus cos theta, so it will become minus cos 45 degree, and this is equal to minus 1 by root 2. Cos 330 degree can be written as cos 270 plus 60 degree, and cos 270 plus theta is sin theta. Being in fourth quadrant, it will be positive, so it will be sin 60 degree, and sin 60 is root 3 by 2, so its value will be root 3 by 2. It was about the T ratios for 270 degree plus theta. Now we come to the T ratios for 360 degree minus theta. In order to make angle 360 degree minus theta, we are considering that our line, which is this time lying in fourth quadrant, because 360 minus theta will lie in fourth quadrant, is making an angle theta with positive x-axis. If OP will make angle theta with positive x-axis, then from positive x-axis, angle made by line in anticlockwise direction, because angle in anticlockwise direction is always taken as positive, will be 360 degree minus theta. And if this angle is 360 degree minus theta, then for 360 degree minus theta, perpendicular will be obtained by drawing a normal from P on base, that is on x-axis. If foot of the normal is n, then for 360 degree minus theta, perpendicular will be PN, that is negative, base will be ON, that is positive. Also, for acute angle theta, perpendicular and base will be same. So, in case of 360 degree, there will be no interchange of perpendicular and base. That is why, in this case, sine, cos, tan, cot, sec, cosec, all will remain as such. For sine 360 degree minus theta, perpendicular minus PN and hypotenuse OP. So it will be minus PN upon OP, but PN upon OP is sine theta for angle theta. So it means it will be minus sine theta. Now cos 360 degree minus theta. For cos 360 degree minus theta, base will be ON positive, hypotenuse OP also positive, so it will be ON upon OP, and ON upon OP for angle theta is base upon hypotenuse, and base upon hypotenuse is cos theta, so cos 360 minus theta will remain cos theta only. Tan 360 degree minus theta will be perpendicular upon base, and this will be minus PN upon ON, and PN upon ON for angle theta is tan theta, so it will be minus tan theta. Now cot 360 degree minus theta in the same way will be minus cot theta. Because of 360 degree there will be no interchange, and also 360 minus theta being in fourth quadrant, cot theta will be negative. When we come to sec 360 minus theta in fourth quadrant, sec theta will be positive, so it will be positive, and since there is no interchange of perpendicular and base, sec will remain sec only, so it will give sec theta. When we come to cosec 360 minus theta, then in fourth quadrant cosec will be negative, so minus, it is the case of 360 degree, no interchange, so minus cosec theta. These T ratios for 360 degree minus theta can be used to find first sine 300 degree. It can be written as sine 360 minus 60, and it means sine 360 minus theta means minus sine theta, so minus sine 60 degree, and we know that sine 60 degree is root 3 by 2, so minus root 3 by 2. Cos 315 degree can be written as cos 360 minus 45 degree, and this will be cos 45 only, because in fourth quadrant cos is positive, and it is the case of 360 degree, that's why cos will remain cos only. It will give 1 by root 2. Now cot 330 degree, it can be written as cot 360 minus 30. And cot 360 minus 30 will be minus cot 30. Because in fourth quadrant, cot will be negative. Case of 360 is there, so no interchange. And cot 30 is root 3, so it will give minus root 3. Now we come to the t ratios for 360 degree plus theta. And to obtain the t ratios for 360 degree plus theta, theta angle made by line OP with positive x-axis, then the angle made by line with positive x-axis will be 360 plus theta also. It means 360 plus theta is same as theta. Since 360 plus theta is same as theta, perpendicular and base for 360 plus theta will be perpendicular PN and base ON, and both will be positive. Since perpendicular and base are same and are positive, so again 360 plus theta being in first quadrant, all t ratios will be positive. Sine 360 plus theta will be perpendicular PN upon hypotenuse OP. So PN upon OP is also sine theta, so it will be sine theta. Similarly for other t ratios, it will be cos theta, it will be tan theta, next will be cot theta, next will be sec theta, and this will be cosec theta. It means 360 degree plus theta is same as theta. In the same way, after completing a complete rotation, the angle will remain same. So sine 360 plus theta, sine 720 plus theta, sine 1080 plus theta, all will be sine theta. Now we will use the t ratios for 360 degree plus theta to find the values of a few other t ratios. Say we want to find out sec 390 degree, then it can be written as sec 360 degree plus 30 degree. And we know sec 360 plus theta will be sec theta, so it will be sec 30 degree. Cos 30 is root 3 by 2, so sec 30 will be 2 by root 3. Now tan 405 degree can be written as tan 360 plus 45, and it will be tan 45, and tan 45 degree is 1. Now cos 420 degree can be written as cos 360 plus 60 degree, and it will be cos 60 degree. Cos 60 is sin 30, that is 1 by 2. So in this way we can use t ratios for 360 degree plus theta to find other t ratios. Now we will determine t ratios for angle minus theta. Angle minus theta means the angle theta is measured in clockwise direction. So this angle made by rotating line OP with positive x-axis will be minus theta. And we can see that this angle minus theta is equivalent to the angle 360 degree minus theta, because magnitude of angle XOP is theta. Sense of rotation being opposite, it is giving negative sign. Hence magnitude being theta, the angle made by line OP with positive x-axis in anticlockwise direction will be 360 minus theta. It means minus theta and 360 minus theta both are same. So whatever was true for 360 minus theta will be true for minus theta also. If we want to find out normal for angle minus theta, then we will have to draw perpendicular from P on x-axis, that is on reference line. If foot of the normal is n, then PN will be perpendicular for angle minus theta, and this perpendicular will be negative, while base ON will be positive. For angle theta also perpendicular and base will be same, because magnitude of this angle is theta, so magnitude wise it is theta, but with magnitude and sine of rotation it is minus theta. So for theta as well as for minus theta, perpendicular and base are same. Since there is no interchange of perpendicular and base, so there will be no interchange of sine into cos or cos into sine, tan into cot or cot into tan, like that. Now if we want to find out sine minus theta, that will be perpendicular, that is minus PN upon hypotenuse OP. And for angle theta, perpendicular will be PN, base will be ON, and theta being angle less than 90 degree, the ratio will be taken as positive. So PN upon OP, yani perpendicular upon hypotenuse, will give sin theta. So this will be minus sin theta. For cos minus theta will be base ON upon hypotenuse OP, and this will be base upon hypotenuse for theta also, so it will be cos theta. So cos theta is positive because minus theta is lying in fourth quadrant. Tan minus theta will be negative because in fourth quadrant tan is negative, so minus, and tan theta will remain as such. It will be minus cot theta, but this will be plus sec theta, because in fourth quadrant sec will be positive. Here it will be minus cosec theta. Thus, in general, we can say whenever there will be an odd integral multiple of pi by 2 plus minus theta, then perpendicular and base will interchange. So interchange of sine into cos or cos into sine, tan into cot or cot into tan, sec into cosec or cosec into sec will take place. But for 2n pi plus minus theta, we will come back to the same position. It means 2n pi plus minus theta is equivalent to 2 plus minus theta. 2n pi plus theta will be theta, 2n pi minus theta will be theta, and in this case there will be no interchange of perpendicular and base, hence sine will remain sine, cos will remain cos, tan will remain tan, like that. Now we can find out the value of T ratios for some angles. As say, first we want to find out tan minus 315 degree, then it can be written as tan minus theta is equal to minus 10 theta, that is minus 10, 315 degree. Now 315 degree can be written as minus 10, 360 minus 45 degree, and 360 minus theta is minus theta. It means again it will be 10 minus theta, means minus minus plus. So minus minus 10, 45 degree, and 10 45 degree is 1, so it will give plus 1. Now cos minus 9 45 degree, in case of cos minus theta is cos theta, so it will be cos 945 degree, and it can be written as cos 720 plus 225 degree. And 720 means 360 plus 360, and cos 360 plus theta will be cos theta, so cos 720 plus theta will be cos theta, so it will be cos 225 degree. And 225 degree can be written as 180 plus 45 degree, so it can be written as cos 180 plus 45 degree. And in case of 180 degree, there will be no interchange. 180 plus 45 will lie in third quadrant, and in third quadrant cos will be negative, so it will be minus cos 45 degree, and this will be minus 1 by root 2. Now sine 1290 degree, it can be written as sine 1080 plus 210 degree. 1080 is multiple of 360. 363 are 1080. So sine 1080 plus 210 will be equivalent to sine 210. So it will be sine 210 degree. And it can be written as sine 180 plus 30 degree. And in case of 180 degree, again there will be no interchange. And 180 plus 30 will lie in third quadrant. In third quadrant, sine will be negative. So it will be minus sine 30 degree. And sine 30 is 1 by 2, so it will be minus 1 by 2.